it was just a little bit awkward situation. I remember that was something which I have never seen in my life before. That is something which I remember like was going on my nerves.
Yeah,
honestly.
That was bothering yeah. you. Hi everybody and welcome back to our channel. I'm Sarah, a Canadian that's been living in Croatia for almost a decade now.
Hi, and I'm Ivan, Sarah's husband who lived in Croatia for decades.
Okay, so we just kind of wanted to do a video about Ivan's experiences in Canada because we lived there together for a couple years a while back. I've talked a lot about my experiences here in Croatia as a Canadian, and many people have asked about Ivan's opinions of Canada. So Ivan's going to give you some insight to how he felt when we were living in Canada.
Yes, exactly. I went in Canada just when I finished my school.
And why did you come to Canada?
I came because of you.
So yeah. We came to each other's countries for each other, yes. Basically. Also, just like a quick timeline. So I first came to Croatia in 2007, and that's when we met and started dating. And that first time around, I lived here for a year, and then I moved back to Canada because I just only planned on being here for a year. So I moved back to Canada. We did long distance for a while, and then eventually even decided to move to Canada so that we could continue to be together.
Together, yes. Yeah. I was waiting to finish my school.
Yeah, so his university.
That, yeah. Mm. So
actually, you didn't even go to your graduation. You came like right yeah. after, as soon as you could, after your last exam.
After I defended my thesis, I left maybe a week after that. Yeah. So.
Okay, so maybe like let's talk about first impressions. Mm-hmm. I mean, generally, like what were your first impressions when you came?
Okay, one of the first impressions when I came out of the airport and we started to drive towards the city was the highways, which are way I don't know, like wider than in Croatia, I would say.
More
with
lanes,
so many
way more
lanes. Yeah. So, and also the cars are bigger than in Croatia.
That's true.
usually people in Canada like SUVs.
Mm-hmm. SUVs, yeah.
SUVs. Yeah, that was definitely first difference which I noticed.
That you noticed.
Yeah. When I came on Canadian soil. What I noticed when I went in the store, people would say to me, "Hi, how are you doing?" You know,
it's our normal greeting in Canada. Hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing?
Yes, and I was like a little bit like weird out because I like we don't say that in Croatian, "Bok kakusi," when you come in the store. Maybe like if you know someone for a while,
but strangers,
not like stranger. Yeah. How are you? You know, or how are you doing? And I was like kind of like weirded out by that question.
Like, how do you answer it? Do you say?
Yeah, like, I want to tell him like, okay, I'm okay. I mean. Thank you for question, you know, or something like
Thank
that.
You for asking.
I thought like, you know, I thought that he's seriously asking me how I'm doing.
Are.
Yeah, so
he I like to take time to explain to him.
And that was like a little bit like, and then like, I don't know. It was just a little bit awkward situation. I remember that was like just small.
And like it wasn't just that person; it was everyone kept asking.
Yeah, everyone said like, "How are you? How are you doing?" You know, like just like that was normal. Hi.
I mean, that's like a greeting in Canada. You just say, "Hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing?" Not really expecting a response, but even thought people were genuinely asking him every single time.
That's one funny thing which I don't know, remember from beginning, but then after that you kind of get used to it.
And you started using it too?
Yeah, you started using it too, or also like you already have ready for me. "I'm good, how are you?"
Yeah.
That's it. You only ask "hakusi" or "how are you?"
If like, you know someone, and you really want to know how they're doing.
Yeah,
so it's
you want
not
to answer, "Are you okay? Are you not okay?"
Yeah,
you know?
It's not part of a greeting here. So
it would be funny that I would say like, "Oh, I'm not going well," you know, to the guy who was like, "What?" Or,
"Can we talk about it?"
Oh, I have a headache today.
If you're enjoying this video so far, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos all about Croatia, beautiful places, culture,
people,
everything.
Food.
Croatian.
One other thing which was very, very funny for me in Canadian supermarkets is Canadian milk. Which was always, which not always, but you can buy it in the bags.
Most people buy it in bags. That was very normal to me growing up. And then as I grew up, I realized that wasn't normal to the rest of the world.
Yes.
That we buy milk in bags, like plastic bags.
Exactly. And yeah. In Croatia, you cannot. I don't think so that you can buy milk in bag. Yeah. You know, in plastic bags.
Yeah. And then you put it in like a plastic jug, and you snip off a little top. That's how it works in Canada.
And it's always 2%. Like
that's the most common. Is 2%.
Yeah, which in Croatia is a little bit like...
Here it's like 3% is more of the common, 2.8, I would say. 2.8,
That's the regular. Yeah. Like, so.
When you got here, you were kind of weirded out by this lack of coffee culture, the way that it is in Croatia and a lot of Europe.
I mean, it was definitely different for me because actually... You don't have coffee bars like in Croatia, where you can sit and the waiter will come and order you coffee and bring you coffee and, you know, you will be served. There are coffee shops where you go and
get your coffee. Find your spot.
Yes, at the bar or how to say at the counter.
You get it at the counter and then you go and find your spot with everything in hand already.
Exactly, coffee bars. Basically.
Yeah, I love coffee culture here. It's just so nice. You go, you sit down at like an open cafe, and the server will come to you, take your order, and just bring you your coffee, and it's just very. Not stressful at all. You just find your spot and you're just nicely served. And I really like that about these Croatian cafes. So that same thing doesn't really exist in
Canada. If you will do that in the restaurant in Canada, I don't think so that I would be happy if you just order coffee and just go.
If you went somewhere and just ordered coffee, they probably wouldn't be thrilled. Yeah.
And also it's funny about Canadian coffees that they are huge.
Huge.
They're like, you got like liter coffee in Canada and it's very, very watered. Also, a big difference is drive-thrus.
Mm-hmm.
In Croatia, you have basically one company which does drive-thru, which is McDonald's.
Yeah, that's like basically the only drive-thru is McDonald's. I don't know any of other.
And in Canada, there are so many of them.
I mean, for fast food, every chain basically has a drive-thru. Yeah. Plus you have, there are like drive-through bank machines.
Oh my God. Yeah, that is something which I have never seen in my life before. That is a drive-through bank machine. So yeah.
Like an ATM.
So yeah, that's something which is
strange for you.
I have never seen driving culture.
In driving culture, for sure.
You drive there everywhere, especially if you live in suburb, drive.
How else did you notice about like faster pace of life? Like it definitely is a faster pace of life there.
Well, when I came in Canada, I noticed that people are walking faster there.
Oh, that's true.
And I was slow walker. And Sarah in the beginning was a little bit annoyed by me because
I wasn't annoyed by you. I just would have to always stop myself into like, just, I don't know. I just had to learn to slow down a little bit and enjoy a little bit.
No, I just like, I don't know, that was my pace. I didn't want like, if it would be like faster, then that would be like fast walking for me going to work.
No,
so.
I think people are just like in a rush there all the time. Yeah. And so people walk really faster, they do. Yeah, I've definitely slowed down my walking since I moved to Croatia 100%. I've just definitely slowed down my pace. And now when I go back to Canada for a visit, I notice that. Especially like with my brother, he's the fastest walker in the world. Actually, like a light jog to keep up with his walking. So I don't know. We've like kind of like matched each other's pace now. So we just enjoy nice little strolls together.
Yeah, I started to walk a little bit faster, and Sarah a little bit slowed down. So
a little compromise there.
Yeah. And now we're walking okay, same pace.
Same pace. But it's nice. I mean, I now enjoy the slower pace.
Yeah, the prices, it's not included the tax.
Yeah.
So
if in any store, not just supermarkets,
in the mall, and when you're buying some electronics or something like
anything.
That. Yeah. So if you're a tourist and coming in Canada and you're not informed, like I was informed, because
I wouldn't think to tell someone that because that's natural for me that everything is without tax.
You can be surprised if you go to the cashier and you know want to pay something and they add you in that time was 13% more of the price which you were thinking. So that was a big surprise.
Yeah.
I don't know why they do that. In Croatia, they showed you in every store you see the total price.
The total price that you'll have to pay, including tax, including everything.
Yes, and in Canada, you basically get that on the receipt.
At the end, so you just kind of learn to calculate an approximate 13% on whatever you're buying, so you know your price. But Yeah, if you aren't used to that, then you can definitely be surprised at the cash register, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
Okay, let's talk about like restaurants and dining out and service, because I know that's a hot topic. When I brought it up in the video that I did about differences in culture and how the service is different here, a lot of Croatians are very against the North American style of service in restaurants.
That's true. I'm not a big fan of that.
Yeah.
As a Croatian, I like to have my piece at the table. First time or second time when we went in the restaurant, one waiter, I remember, he was just constantly coming and trying to like chat with us. And I was like, you know, I was first thinking that he knows Sarah, but you know, like it's just like in Croatia, it's definitely different.
Very different. Yeah,
you get your meal. If sometimes they come, sometimes not.
Usually not during your meal. As soon as you get your meal.
Is everything okay? Okay. Mm. And he goes and then you ask him the bill. They don't bring you, you know.
Yeah. Let's talk about now seasons. Seasons of the year.
Yes. Canada, definitely. It's missing one season and that's spring. Uh-huh. It's a pretty cold spring, which I noticed because the winter can last longer.
Mm-hmm, that's true. Yeah.
And summer then just immediately starts in June.
Yeah. It's weird because in Canada, it's just
that was my experience from two years. So,
but it's very, very unpredictable. Yeah. Like it could be snowing in May, and then like the next day you could be wearing shorts. Like it's very unpredictable in the spring in Canada. I would say
that's definitely true.
And whereas here in Croatia, it's like more of a beautiful spring. Like you get nice spring weather to warm you up to winter, to summer.
Oh yeah, we can talk a little bit about Canadian winters.
Yeah.
Which are, which also surprised me actually both years when I was there, because I expected that winter will come earlier, and you know, in November,
like October,
or even October, But it didn't. It came actually in December.
Yeah, like the strong cold. Yeah, of course, it gets colder in November.
Yeah, because also,
in Zagreb, the same type of thing.
November is also could be chilly.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But real difference actually came in December. When it started the real winter, and I've never felt that cold in my life. One day I remember it was like minus 35, and that's like, that's, I don't know. You couldn't even describe how is that cold, you know? Like you put like so many layers, but you still feel it.
You know? It's chilly.
It's chilly, and and then, it was chilly, and you kind of get used to it because it's mostly sunny, you know? It's not cloudy, it's not foggy like here in Zagreb during the winter, so. It's okay, it's minus 10, it's sunny, you know.
Yeah,
like
it just makes it feel better because it's sunny.
Sunny. It's you know, like doesn't
pretty
affect your mood.
Pretty clear, yeah.
But it's what gets you, it's last long. So, in Croatia, winter basically now disappears in February. They're like, there are like also
some colder days in March.
Yeah,
but...
in March. But February is basically now done. You know, winter is it's not anymore so cold. Canada, I remember it was end of March, it was still minus 10, minus 20, you know. Oh my god, when we'll pass that? And then came April and it was again like, I don't know, like minus 5 here and there, you know. So it's
longer winters.
It's longer winter, and that is something which I remember like was going on my nerves.
Yeah,
honestly.
That was bothering you. Yeah. One last snowfall in May, and then.
that's very probably rare now, but probably when you're younger.
It's not so rare. It's not so rare.
Like comes June and it's summertime.
Yeah,
you know?
Like plus 25, and you're in shorts and ready to go. Yeah.
So definitely, Canadian winters are long.
Yeah.
Why I enjoy in the Canadian weather, I mean Canadian summer there. When I was coming to Canada, I have here in Croatia allergies on grass.
They really bother him.
Bother him. And I brought there lots of...
He stocked up on his allergy meds, like stocked up.
Because
like...
I don't know how they were accessible in Canada. And I came there and there, I didn't feel any
like
allergies.
You didn't sneeze once.
Yeah.
Like there was not a drop of allergies there. So
definitely Canada has
there's
some
something,
other
kind
of grass which doesn't bother me here in Zagreb.
Yeah. Especially. It was allergy free for 2 years.
For 2 years. And I came back in Zagreb again, same thing. So that was really good. I was, and I'm a big fan of sport.
Yeah.
So when I came in Canada, it was definitely different for me to see that people really love hockey, and Toronto Maple Leafs were definitely, and they are still, the most popular club in Toronto, and people are crazy for hockey. Everything is hockey.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was definitely different to see how people are more about hockey. Also, what I noticed, people were playing hockey during the winter in the parks.
Yeah.
They were like open rinks. So,
which is so great.
So it's basically like in Croatia, how kids come to the field and
play soccer.
They were coming there playing hockey during the winter. That was so cool, and that was the main thing, you know, to do. So yeah, it's definitely different sport culture, because Canadians love their hockey.
Even also learned to skate when he was in Canada.
Actually, I learned how to
skate on one of the outdoor rinks in the public park.
Yes, exactly,
I remember that.
Exactly,
night.
I bought the skates and Sarah actually
at Canadian
me.
Tire.
Yeah, the Canadian tire.
And I taught even how to skate.
Yeah, I think in 2 days I was skate.
Yeah.
I mean, basically, you know, just doing rounds.
Yeah.
So yeah,
it was fun. A good little skater.
Yeah.
No, I loved our time in Toronto together.
Yeah, it was fun. Yeah. We were young and it was like young and crazy.
Yeah, we were a little young and crazy there, and I don't know, we had a good time
That was a great time.
Yeah. Yeah, we like started our life adventure together, basically. Right.
those years were really special for me, and Canada will definitely be in my heart, you know, as my second favorite country in the world.
Canada. We hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.